So I would say you've been living in Germany for at least 10 years now, maybe longer. So what would you say are the pros and cons of living in Germany?
Oh my gosh, man.
Just a few.
Okay, so the cons are, and people are probably going to laugh at this. The cons are, I always tell, when new players come to the teams here, I always tell them, here's one thing. Make sure you do your shopping from Monday to Saturday, because on Sunday, the grocery stores are closed. Oh, okay. Everything is closed. Mm-hmm. So if you forget to buy milk, eggs, bread, snacks, and so on, yeah, you got to wait till Monday to do that. So and please, if there's a holiday on a Saturday or something like this as well, then you're talking like 2 days or a weekend that's shut down, where it makes it difficult. So that's a con, because you're so used to this 24 hours, 7 days a week, everything in the States being open. But understand this, in Germany, that's not. The benefits to that, though, is, and this is what I've come to appreciate in my years of being here, is, you're talking, and I don't want to use this too much in a biblical sense, but, as it stays in the Bible, the good Lord rested, on the seventh day. And I think, the culture of Germany is really embedded in those words within itself. Mm-hmm. That on Sunday, it's a rest day. You're not allowed to work on your house and use loud machinery, mm-hmm. And so on. And, it's really like saying, no, look, you work hard from Monday to Saturday. Mm-hmm. That's great. But on Sunday, just relax. So that's one of the things. But, again, the positives is, if I have to look at it from this aspect of being, a family man and so on, is, and I think we shared this off camera, was, the health insurance.
Mm-hmm. True.
Understanding that, everyone that lives here is covered under the health insurance policies that have been brought out. So, you hurt yourself and you go to the hospital, you don't have to worry about, am I covered on my insurance for certain injuries, mm-hmm. or, the crown in my tooth just came out, I have to go to the dentist, but do I have insurance? You don't have to worry about any of that. All those things are being, they're taken care of. So, those are, some of the pros and some of the cons, but gosh, a lot of these things just depends on your outlook on life. And, I'm a very positive person, and I try my best to instill, positive vibes and energy into any and everybody that is around me. And so it's kind of one of those things that's the only con for me.
Okay.
It sounds a bit weird, but, it's just the shopping. Mm-hmm. There's a lot. I bake a lot. Mm-hmm. I cook a lot. So, there's some things that when I wake up in the morning, on a Saturday, and I get to thinking, oh, I want to bake these cookies for the boys, or I want to make some protein shakes or something like this to get them on their way. Mm-hmm. And then on Sunday, I'm like, oh, wait a minute, we don't have any milk. So, yeah, that's not going to work. I guess I got to do it with water or so on. But yeah, that's it. I usually tell people, before you take the words of another man or woman or another person, simply get some things together that you want. And if you want to go and visit another country, by all means, go. And you have to experience it for yourself, because my pros may be your cons, and your cons may be my pros. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? So come and travel. And gain your own experiences.
All right. So what's one thing that sticks out to you that you've been able to learn while living outside of the U.S.?
It's a good question. It's a very good question. One of the things that I've learned outside of being in the U.S. is patience. Don't have to always think that, we got to be on the go. I have to, I told a friend of mine, if you take a person out of, like, let's say out of LA or out of New York or out of, you know, Georgia or out of Atlanta or something like this, people that come from very huge metropolitan areas where you're constantly on the go, you got to get up and go get it. If you take that and you bring these people here, for me, for my understanding with that is like, gosh, now you've created a whole different deal, because now I can still be that same get up in the morning and go get it type of person, mm-hmm. but knowingly that if I don't hit my mark, I know that I'm okay. Mm-hmm. I know that the governmental system is going to help me somehow, some way. Mm-hmm. And this is one of those, we talk about pros and cons. This is a pro, another pro to it. Mm-hmm. But what I've learned through the process is that I don't have to always be, let me get up and mm-hmm. let me go and grind and let me grind. It's patience. Mm-hmm. It's let me get up, let me enjoy, my mornings. Let me get up and go for a walk. Let me get up and take the kids, to the park, and let me go and enjoy, my family time. And, let me enjoy my friends, and let's enjoy life. Because what's going to come is going to come.
You know? Right. The little things.
The little things, exactly.